Everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, all of you. We have 4 more minutes to go for this powerful conversation we're going to have between Professor Josh, Dr. Jagdish Ji, and Romi Vadera, all the way from USA. We could see him. Thank you so much, Romi, for joining in. And we will do, kind of will edify you, and then we'll be inviting you. You can stop your video as well if you like, or unmute your video, Romi. It's up to you. Shashi sir, Romi is already there.
Okay, you can hear me.
Yep.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, 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 Romi. India welcomes you. Panacea SUO welcomes you on this platform.
Thank you. Thank you.
Today is a historic moment for this platform. Romi Verdera, our chief guest, special speaker for today's session, the Friday Water Educators Forum, which is running into its 35th week. And we all are blessed. This part of the world is really blessed. And what we are going to witness is two great personalities. The first one, yes, Romi Verdera, 6A, 12-6, guys, virtual clap. Yes, 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 blessings to Romi Verdera. It's one of the topmost leadership position that everybody would want to be there. It is even beyond Hall of Fame, rather. So, Romi, thanks for accepting our invite for being on today's platform. And then, the host for today is also an extraordinary legend personality, Dr. Jagdish. He's a former ISRO scientist, Indian Space Research Organization scientist, and he's a water re-engineer, energy re-engineer. You talk of any re-engineering, he's there, certified and qualified, not only academically, but also in terms of his experience and expertise of more than 4 decades. So a big clap for Jagdish sir, our Panacea chief mentor, onto this platform. Without him, this platform would not have been so powerful. Thank you, Jagdish sir, for all your contributions. And with this, we will take the proceedings forward, and Anil will take it forward with our introductory video of the Panacea panel. The Panacea brand ambassadors, people have put this program together. We acknowledge them, gratitude to each one of them, and gratitude to all the participants, those who are here. So over to Anil for the proceedings. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Shashi sir. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. So we have 1 more minute to go for this powerful conversation on a magic Kangen Water talk show on our SUO, the World of the Panacea platform. Thank you so much, Romi, for accepting invite to be the chief guest. And, we are really excited to take this ahead today. So 1 more minute to go, ladies and gentlemen, and you can share the FB streaming link with all your friends, your near ones, dear ones, ladies and gentlemen. This is already streaming live on FB. So you can do your, watch parties there. Okay, so it's 9:34 p.m. IST here. Thanks so much. Happy morning, afternoon, and evening to all of you with yes, yes, yes energy. And, before we kickstart, let's look at SUO, the World of the Panacea team and all our members, just to give you a heads up on this team, which is working relentlessly for the last 35 weeks, on Friday and Saturday with all international guests coming in. Thanks once again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sharing my screen. Let's go over this introductory video of SUO, the World of the Panacea. Right, here we go. Okay. Right. Thank you. provide. That's the video, and a very powerful one. Thanks so much, Arundhati ma'am, our co-founder. Arundhati ma'am is the one who was the the brainchild behind this fantastic, powerful video. Ladies and gentlemen, taking much time, let me introduce our two powerful people. Professor Jagdish sir is the our chief mentor for ESTRO, the World Above the Panacea team, and a scientist for Indian Space Research Organization. And he has worked with who's of all the big industries, the industrialists like Ambani's, and he has worked in the artificial intelligence segment for so many years. And he's going to be taking on this conversation with very powerful ROMI VERDERA 6812-6, all the way from USA, ladies and gentlemen. Let me quickly share screen and introduce all of you. I don't think it needs any introduction, but as a protocol here, we really want to introduce our guest, ROMI VERDERA from USA, a global energetic leader, rank 6812-6, which is one of the dream ranks for any of the energetic distributors worldwide. A global top income earner, master trainer for energetic business, expert in success mindset, and perfect strategist for energetic business growth. So that's ROMI VERDERA. So, I'm going to invite here Professor Jagdish sir to take this ahead. And I'm really, really excited to have this, to witness this powerful conversation on Energetic Kangen Water talk show on ESTRO, the World of the Panacea. With that note, thanks everyone for joining in here. So over to you, Jagdish sir. Thanks a lot. Thank you.
Thank you, Anil. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So good morning, ROMI.
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you today?
I'm good. We're good. It's very cold here in New York.
great. So let me first welcome you to this Panacea Itsubo Kangen Water Talk Show. This is the 35th week, as you know. Just a couple of sentences about, this is for education and for giving all the skills that are required to be a successful, energetic business distributor, to be successful and reach greater heights. All that is done on Fridays is basically on the education, and Saturday we have nourish and flourish. That is where we say nourish is like the properties of kangen water, and all that product demo is there, and then the business plan, the compensation plan. So this is what and then we bring the experts in this, like you, and on Fridays and Saturdays is mostly on the product demo. Again, there, like people like Amanda and, there's other people have also, international people also come into on the Saturdays. And this is successful, and it is open to all, as you might have been briefed by Shashi. This is for all. It is not like a particular line of sponsorship. Okay, so that is in brief about this forum, and we are very, very fortunate that you have agreed to be here and then give your valuable time. And it is my privilege to host you and to be able to get the best out of you for the benefit of everyone who is present here. And I have heard you in this recent Malaysia conference. I was very much, I learned a lot in that particular session. I also, had a look at your videos on your, 6asuccess.com. And yes, and then you, I'm sure you have the list of questions that we have shared with you, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. So before I start with the first question, friends, let me welcome the Panacea mentors, the brand ambassadors, and all the participants over here. Get ready with your pen and, for taking notes. There'll be a lot of points that you can jot down and make it as a reference, later time and again. So are you ready? If you are ready for starting this important, powerful session, please type yes, 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 and be alert all the while. Okay, can I have yes, yes, yes from all of you, and then start hearing from ROMI. Okay, so ROMI, the first thing that we would like to know from you is your journey before energetic.
and also your million-dollar story, right? So this is something that all of us are very eager to hear from you. Can you please?
Okay. I originally came from the Philippines, and when I was young, I live in a poor rural area. My father was a government employee. He made very little money. And I used to see my uncle, who is a businessman. And I love my father so much, but then my uncle, I like his lifestyle, you know. He owns a store, a bakery shop, a gasoline station. So he lived well. So from my youth, I like the character of my father, who is loving and gentle and humble. And I also like the lifestyle of my uncle. So I wanted a combination of both. So when I was 22 years old, I married my wife. She was 18. I just finished college. And my plan before was really to go into business and not work a 9-to-5 job. Like my father. But when we went to America, and I had my two young kids, like that dream was lost. Like for several years, I became a regular office worker, accounting clerk. I worked like at a Dunkin' Donut shop, being a cashier, you know. And I thought that was the end of it. Like I cannot dream in America anymore. I just have to be a regular worker. I have no capital. I have no money. I don't know anybody. And then one day when I was 28 years old, I was invited to a opportunity meeting, a business meeting. And I didn't want to attend, but my friend, he was younger than me. He was 25 years old. He told me, like, don't you have dreams for yourself? Because I didn't want to attend the meeting. And that caught me, you know. So I agreed. I came and I saw this network marketing mirror. You know? At the time, it was actually Amway. But that opened up my mind that, wow, there is this thing called network marketing where with very little money, I could get involved and I can talk to people. So that really caught me. I was 28 years old. So I asked them, what do I have to do to make the kind of money that those successful people are making? You know, what do I need to do? And they told me I have to learn, read books, watch videos, go into self-development. And I was hungry for learning. It was like a whole new world to me. And I started dreaming again. And I did everything they told me. Okay, self-motivation, inspiration, like all these things. I read a Think and Grow Rich book, How to Win Friends and Influence People, The Magic of Thinking Big, The Magic of Believing. I read all the books, watched all the training. It didn't work for me. After 3 months, I recruited one person. He quit. I quit too. but the concept, okay, of being able to dream, the potential of building a team of people who could work with you, and in the long future, you could build a huge organization and you will receive residual income, that stuck with me. So after Amway, I went to another company called Herbalife. Okay, again, I'm 30 years old. I listened to all their trainings again. Okay, I'm saying this because by the time I get to Inagic, which was 20 years later, okay, I actually quit my job at the age of 29. I'm 65 now. So I have not worked a regular job since I was 29. All I did was network marketing. So at age of 29, I figure I learned so much. I quit my job, went full-time into Herbalife. But then problem comes along and I lose my group. But I never went back to work. The dream stayed with me. I want to earn a lot of money. I want to become a millionaire. I want to have a beautiful house. I want to drive nice cars. I want to go around the world, you know. So for the next 20 years here in New York, in the United States, I was dreaming. I was moving one company to the other. And sure enough, I never lost that dream. I never lost that faith, that belief that I will find a company that I could build. And 15 years ago, okay, that was after 20 years in those different companies, I found an Ajik. Okay, I went to California by my invitation of a friend, and I saw Mr. Oshiro spoke on the stage. I heard some distributors who were successful, and that was the beginning of my Enagi career, which was 15 years ago, and the best years of my life was in Enagi.
That's awesome. That's awesome. See, friends, you see here, it's a right example here. You people are so fortunate at whatever stage you have got in. I'm sure, you know, most of you have been very lucky to get into Enagic in much early, unlike, you know, although, you know, Romi today is amongst the top guys, but he got into Enagic, as he said, after more than 20 years trying that and this. Please note this. So you people are very, very fortunate, and we will also hear from him when he started. And today, I am sure it is going to be much easier. I think we'll hear from him. So the next question is about your experience of energy kangen water, you know, in terms of the experience with respect to health, your energy and motivation that kept you going.
Okay, when I went to my first meeting in California, where Mr. Oshiri spoke, at the time there were no, I would say, Caucasian Americans. They were all Orientals at the first meeting that I attended in California, and there was these people from Asia carrying bottled water with kangen water in it. You know, at the time we had no sophisticated bottled water. People were using regular bottled water with kangen water inside. You think they were drinking bottled water, you know? I asked the guy at the meeting, I mean, so what did it do to you, you know? And he told me how he was suffering from gout, and that kept the gout away from him, drinking this kangen water. And that clicked with me right away. Because as I was growing up, I was watching my father suffering from gout, and me too. When I started, I was 50 years old then, and I was starting to suffer also with the same problem. And I said, "Oh my gosh, I got this from my father, and I'm gonna live with this for the rest of my life." Yeah, but that caught my attention. So after that meeting, I bought the machine. Okay. When I came back to New York on payment plan, I started drinking kangen water, and I experienced the same thing. And I really didn't believe in the beginning. I want to do the business, but I was doubtful about the water. But then when I started giving water to people and they started drinking it, I hear all kinds of stories like the way you see on YouTube today from people. And the more people purchase the machine from me, the more stories I get from them, how they felt good. I get so much confidence that we have the perfect product and the easiest thing to sell in the world, this kangen water machine. So I just keep on selling. I actually sold in the group 100 machines on my first 3 months. You know?
Wow.
So
how many direct out of them? 100.
About 15 direct, and then the 85 are their people. But like I said, before Enagic, I was with different companies, so I know these people who like to sell, you know. it was easier for me.
Okay, great. So, see, definitely, you know, there is something that we want to, you know, hear from you with respect to the basic, you know, the success factors, key factors for success in energy, especially the ones who are starting. What are the basics one has to strengthen themselves as a sound foundation, which will help them to, you know, grow and achieve greater heights?
Okay. I can talk to you about like six important basics that I learned through the years. And I just keep on doing it, and that enables me to build. And that's the same thing I used on my first 90 days, okay? Now, I know that the audience listening to me now are at different, I would say, level of experience or background. So for some, it will be like a lot easier to follow. Some still have to be trained into doing it. But these are the very basic thing. Number one is prospecting. Okay, you need to have a yellow pad and put 100 names there. Get it from your address book, from your notebooks, from people that you know. And you have to be a master prospector, because that prospect list is your doorway to building the huge organization. Okay, I see that most people sometimes who had no background in sales or network marketing, after they approach three friends, you know, they say, I don't think I could do this. Like, everybody doesn't want to buy. How many is everybody? Like three or four. You're not going to be successful.
Okay.
So you have to learn the skills. Like becoming an agile distributor is a career. You know, doctors, lawyers would spend 4 years, some 8 years, you know, some 10 years. I mean, and I'm telling you, there are more kangen distributors who make more money than them. Okay, so it's a skill that you have to learn. It's a career, this network marketing thing, this selling thing. So prospecting is one. The second one is doing the demo or selling. Okay, that's easy to learn because you can watch YouTube videos. It's all over the internet now. When I started, there were no YouTube videos. You Google kangen water, there was nothing on the internet when I started 15 years ago. So most of this demonstration you see on the internet now, they were patterned from the first video that I did 15 years ago. Like the three properties of water, the compensation plan. I made a video, you know? Okay, so you have to master that, dropping the pH test, okay? And then you have to master presenting the opportunity, which is the home plan. Okay, now, when I'm doing all those, I always back them up with stories, okay? Because it's the story that sells. You cannot be too technical, and then it becomes boring, because it becomes like a class in school, no? You don't want it to sound like that. You want to be conversational and tell stories and tell, okay. Then, so you have prospecting, selling, presenting the opportunity. And then the fourth one is training, like what we're doing this today, right now. Once they buy the machine and become a distributor, especially on the first few days when they are new. Because when the distributor is new, it's like you have to strike the iron while the iron is hot. They are hot in the beginning. They're really believers of the water. They're believers of the opportunity that you told them. You gotta expose them to training right away. Okay, training right away. And they got to experience some sales immediately. That's why on my first 90 days, my first 3 months, those original 15 people that I sold to, right away I told them, okay, you gather some people in your living room. Okay, there was no pandemic at the time. Now we could do Zoom, you know. You gather people at your living room, and I'm going to do the demonstration, and you're going to watch it. And when they buy, then you get your commission, and that's the opportunity. So right away, I scheduled these meetings. I was doing meetings every single day on my first 90 days, sometimes two or three in one day.
Okay.
I would do it in one house, jump to the other house, you know. So I was hungry. Okay. Okay, so that's training, motivation. You're gonna keep them motivated, okay? Mm-hmm. you gotta keep telling the distributor stories of who succeeded, you know, and make sure your communication with them is always open, because you don't want them to cool down. Once you start having people, you're like a general in the army, say in a desert on a war, but you gotta be connected to them so they don't feel alone and they lose the excitement, okay? Once you become disconnected, they get excited by your stories. That's why they buy, you know? But once you get disconnected, you don't want that to happen to them. You're gonna keep communicating with them, okay? So training, motivation. Now, very important is the sixth one, the last one, which is like self-development. Like, I have to work on myself every day, okay? Anybody who think that they already know everything, you're susceptible to really being stuck and moving backward. I still continue to read, watch videos, excite myself every day, even today, after 35 years, almost 40 years in this industry, network marketing. I got books all over me. I would watch YouTube videos of successful people. I watch successful people, not only in the energy business, anybody who knows how to do marketing, I would watch on videos. I read the books of Anthony Robbins, Zig Ziglar, Jim Rohn. I used to buy their videos, and I hype myself up. Like I have to be always upbeat, you know, every single day. Because people get attracted to you, they could feel your energy, okay, if you're excited. I want to share, okay, in self-development. This was the first book I read a long time ago, Think and Grow Rich, okay? Napoleon Hill. This has all the multimillionaires of the old business in America in the 1920s, you know, late 1800s, Henry Ford, all of them, they're all here, okay? And the author Napoleon Hill spent 25 years gathering all the secrets of the multimillionaires in America and put it in this book. So this was the first book I read. And this is like the Bible of how to become a millionaire. So from the time I read this book when I was in my late 20s, I was a dreamer of becoming a millionaire. I never lost that dream. And they say if you make your first million, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, and so on just keeps coming. You know, it's true. A long, long time ago, I thought it was just like they're just teaching it, you know. But then it really happens. Okay. Now today, there's another book, Tools of Titans. So these are the present day multimillionaires. Okay, Tools of Titans. They're still alive. So. You got Steve Jobs and Microsoft guy. Wow. Everybody's there. Because you want to think like them. You don't become a millionaire until you start thinking like them. You know, you want to capture it. You have to transform your mind, your emotion. Okay.
Wow. So thank you so much. I mean, the so many years, decades of experience you have put together and then given these golden nuggets. Prospecting, demo, storytelling, and the compensation plan, the training, like the one that we have, the motivation, which you very clearly said that you need to do continuously motivation. Motivation, you know, gets depleted. So you have to keep on motivating your team. Then, replacing and self-development. Yes. Wonderful. Yeah. And then you demonstrate here, you know, that you are even today reading and the latest books and all those things. Wonderful. Thank you so much. We are grateful to you for, you know, giving this, so many books together, so many decades of experience in a very nutshell. Before we proceed with the next question, please type the success factors that you understood, the points in chat, so that, you know, there is certain amount of, you know, internalization that happens. And that also helps you to follow the further questions much better. So just type it in the chat and then we'll I'll go ahead with the next question.
You want me to do it?
Yeah.
You want me to do that one? Okay, I don't even know how to type here. there.
Yeah.
Do you want me to type?
No, not you. No. I am asking the participants to type that they are attentive, they are grasping, you know, it's so that, you know, it's the time that they're putting, they're more attentive, and we know that the further proceeding, they will follow better. I'm just requesting the participants to type. Yeah.
Okay.
Just so that they are in sync with the, you know, the proceeding. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah. Romi, the next thing that is very important that we would like to know from you, after knowing the success factors based on your experience, we'd also like to know the causes for failure in energetic business, you know, the top 1, 2, 3, you know, reasons for failure. And you have to take sort of the precautionary measures and be alert on those things.
Okay, I would say it's a universal cause of failure is lack of faith, F-A-I-T-H, belief, okay? Every human being have a belief system. And for instance, being an energetic distributor, you have to believe in yourself that you have the ability, you have the capability to do this business. Now, the belief actually grows with your experience. Okay, for instance, when I was starting, just like everybody else, when you start, I just want to make some extra money. Okay, although I'm always shooting for the $1 million and for the good life. Okay, when you're starting, you just want to make some sales so I could survive, you know. Like when I saw Enagic, I was so broke, you know. So I need money to pay my bills. Okay, so I know this business could like help me pay my bills, and I experienced it right away. And then your belief grows as you go along. You dream bigger, okay? So you come to a level where you go into like a maintenance mode. All my bills are paid, I'm happy, I'm comfortable. And then you move to a higher level where, I mean, you experience some luxuries. You buy a nicer car, you change your address, you buy a bigger house, you know, you travel around the world, you vacation. And then I would say the highest stage would be when you really are earning enough and you go into the contribution level, where you just want to contribute to everybody's life, you know? Like it comes to a point when you don't really even have to work anymore, but you want to contribute to the lives of others because you want them to experience the same success that you have. Like what I'm doing in this webinar, okay? So when you lose that faith, okay, you get stuck and you don't move forward anymore, and you probably like digress, like step back. So in my early life in network marketing, I learned that faith is more important. So I read a whole lot of things about how to maintain my faith, how to maintain my belief. I there's a book called Magic of Believing. Okay, I read that book. And also there's so many sources that you can read. You have to pattern your life to the lives of people who succeeded and who had strong faith. And again, it's like you absorb their their, I would say, character of not giving up, not quitting up, and keep moving forward. It has, that has to be solid in you, because the moment you doubt, you lose it. Okay. Let me pick up a book. I want to show you one session.
Wow.
I'm just gonna get something.
Yeah, sure. Yeah,
I'll be right back.
Yeah, sure. See, please, hear him very carefully. So he's sharing so openly every challenge that he has put in, the lot of effort. So, and then it is a continuous growth. Just within, you know, few months into this, and then say that you can't do it is not fair, because you are not even given a fair try. So that is something, you know, belief grows with time and experience. Wonderful. Yes, please.
See this book, Entrepreneurs, okay? Entrepreneurs.
Entrepreneurs, yes.
Entrepreneurs, okay?
Yeah.
I read this when I was younger. And many of the brand names, stories of people are here. Like for instance, I was just reading this week again. I thought of getting this from my library and scan through it again. There's one guy named, see that chewing gum, Wrigley chewing gum? Do you have that in India too, Wrigley chewing gum?
Yes, yes.
Do you know what that guy did was, he was a soap salesman, okay? Selling soap. And this was like at the turn of the century, mm-hmm. the ancient America, door to door soap salesman. Right. And then there came out this chewing gum. It was like something new. And he would put two chewing gum on the soap that he's selling. And then he found out that people, most of these mothers who were buying soap, would come back to him and said, "We want more of the chewing gum, you know, before the soap like is finished. They want more chewing gum." So he ended up selling chewing gum instead. His name is Mr. Wrigley, Bill Wrigley.
Okay,
Mr. Wrigley, Wrigley's chewing gum. Anyway, what he did, he's a good marketer. So that's where I'm learning. He took the here in the United States we have what we call telephone directory, okay, of everybody that have a telephone in America. And that was way back in the early 1900s, no? And he mailed 4 chewing gums to all the addresses.
Innovative, yeah.
Do you know, he became a multi-millionaire until now. It has become a huge company.
Yeah, I have a question.
Yeah.
Yeah, before that. Before I forget, I wanted this. What can be the chewing gum for promoting in Agic program?
Okay, let me tell you what I did. When I started 15 years ago, there were no YouTube videos about in Agic, no demo, no nothing, no training. And I have this 100 people on my first 90 days, and how do I train them? Okay, now I learned that in network marketing the secret is duplication. I should be able to duplicate what I'm doing to them. They should be able to do it. So what I did after 1 year in Enagic, like the chewing gum guy, I created DVDs
of my
demonstration, and I gave it to everybody, and everybody was playing it on people's homes, DVDs. And in 2007, my second year in Enagic, I distributed 40,000 DVDs. Like the chewing gum guy. 40,000 DVDs. You don't even have to do that anymore, because now we have YouTube video. You just send the links, you know, or you do the Zoom.
So easy, Zoom. You just share the links.
Yeah. I had to produce a DVD and mail it to people.
Yes.
To come to people something, show it. So, but you gotta keep connected. You have to, whatever you do it massively. Okay? You do it massively. That's the lesson there. So the cause of failure, okay, I would say number one is when you stop believing, or when you're not flexible, or when you are not creative, okay, you gotta be creative. You always have to have new ideas. Like if you have a stumbling block, you think of another way to go through it. I learned that also from Mr. Oshiro. Mr. Oshiro says, you just keep moving forward. You don't back up. Keep if you make a mistake, that's okay. You just correct it as you go along, you know? So I think I answered
this. Yeah, sure. And you also said, you know what, in the, today's context also you indicated, okay, massive action. So maybe you can use social media or whatever. You have to be innovative. There is, and the tools are too many available now. And technology is so advanced. And during our days, Romi, you know, these are all days where we had, getting a book used to take days, you know. Today it's just click of button, you know. So yeah, lovely. Thank you. And the going forward, we would like to hear from you a very important, you know, head knowledge versus art knowledge. That is what you say, especially, you know, what we have to learn is to learn to learn, and, you know, from knowing, you know, to doing, you know, your, value addition, and then we like to hear straight from you.
Yeah, that's very important. The head knowledge and the heart knowledge. Okay.
Yeah.
By head knowledge, I'm talking about, sometimes we hear this saying that knowledge is power. That's actually wrong. Knowledge is only potential power.
Yes.
You can have all the knowledge in the world, but it's just potential. If you don't use it, it doesn't do you any good. Okay. So again, when I was younger, I became very familiar with the importance of understanding how we think. Okay. Because you can read, for instance, a book on how to swim or how to ride a bicycle. You can finish the whole book. You still don't know how to ride a bicycle. You still don't know how to swim, okay? So you learn by doing it, okay? You learn by doing it. You go on the bike, you learn to balance, you go into the swimming pool, you learn to float, okay? And it's the same thing with this business. Like you could be, you find people going to training after training after training and still doesn't succeed because again, it doesn't convert into you call it heart knowledge or like body memory.
That's body memory, yes.
Body memory or heart knowledge, yeah. Okay? It becomes a real part of you. I mean, you could read, for instance, I read a whole lives of like really, I like reading biographies of multimillionaires, you know. I read Steve Jobs, like everybody here in America, and I read the story of Honda, Mr. Honda, okay. By reading those, you get excited, but then you have to start doing what they do, because that's when you digest it, and it really becomes a part of you. It really becomes a part of you. So once you I just taught you about prospecting. I know, for instance, I'm looking here. We have 82 participants listening here. I wonder how many after listening to this would really get a paper and put 100 names, you know, because if you don't, you just missed it. Just that first one. Okay. And it has to become a habit. Okay. When on the second company I joined when I was like in my early 30s, company named Herbalife. There's a guy named Larry Thompson. Larry Thompson, the trainer of Herbalife, have an audio tape. Mm-hmm. The title of the audio tape is Millionaire Training Tape. Okay. I have listened to the tape maybe 100 times or more. over and over. I listen to the tape and I still remember what the tape says. And I apply it, I do it, okay? And what the tape says is, basically, on one of the part of the tape, he says, talk to 10 people a day. Talk to 10 people a day. Could you imagine listening to the tape over? I already know it, you know, but I still listen to it because I want it to really digest it and become part of me. And how did it become part of me? I took a notebook at one point, and I wrote like 1 to 10. So say January 1 to January 30, I got 1 to 10. And I make sure I will put names there of who were those 10 people that I spoke to today. Okay. And honestly, I would confess, I never, ever had a day where I really spoke to 10. never made it. You know?
But still,
I know I'm making an effort to talk to some people every day. I would talk to 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe 6, 7. You know, I'm making an effort to do it. And you don't cheat yourself. You don't talk to the same person tomorrow and then put it in again. You got to talk to new people in your prospect list. Like, how many calls did you do today? You know, how many demos did you do? How many email did you send? You know, how many follow ups you did on your downline? You're gonna put the numbers. So it becomes I think Daniel DeMacali calls it like some operating procedure that becomes natural to you, that you just keep doing it. See, once it becomes part of you, if you don't do it for the day, you feel like something's wrong. Like you're just not happy anymore. You're not contented. You knew you blew the day, you know. Like, for instance, I sold insurance also, and I remember, so I learned from a lot of people. My insurance manager at one point was the top manager in the whole United States. So I was fortunate to become part of that team of people that he trained, you know. And this is what I learned from him. He said, if you're doing sales full time, if you do not have an appointment for the day, you're not called a salesman for that day. You are called unemployed. I don't want to be unemployed on any given day. So I want to have an appointment. I have to call somebody. I got to do something.
Rumi, I have a question for you here.
Okay.
How do we help people who do not like marketing and sales?
Okay, I had the same problem in the beginning. Like when I was new, I don't like to sell, you know. So again, I know that I have to learn to like to sell for me to enjoy doing it. So again, I read books. And then I found out, okay, I read the book, for instance, of a guy named Joe Girard. At one point, he was the number one car salesman in the whole United States. And I read his book. How did he became? The title of the book is How I Raised Myself from Failure to Success in Selling. And I learned so much from that book. I don't even see that book on the bookstore anymore. I still remember the lessons I learned there, you know?
Yeah, Rumi, what comes to my mind here is to ask you, well, learn to sell is fine as a networking, selling cars, you said, but how do you think it is this particular energy, you know, the product is different from selling cars? And what is the plus point in, you know, in this? Can you highlight?
Okay. Yeah. The plus point we have, because again, I sold a lot of different things. And like I said, for 20 years before in Agic, I don't know how many products, you name it, I sold it. Encyclopedia Britannica, insurance, real estate, vitamins, water filters,
so many
electronics,
things.
You know, too many. This is the one I love selling the most, energy. Okay, because in the other companies, nobody comes back to you and tell you stories of how good it did them. Here in Enagic, they come back to you and they thank you, you know, that you introduce them to the water. It feels so good when you change somebody's life. You change families. You know? You change the life of people. And these are God-given product to human beings to maintain the health of people. Okay, because we were created to be healthy. Okay, that's the natural flow of creation of things, that we are supposed to be healthy. I know there are some exceptions, but the natural thing is we should be healthy. And people do a lot of things that ruins their health, you know. They bring in the wrong food and people get sick. When I was younger, I even smoked cigarette too. You bring in the wrong air. And thank God I stopped a long time ago when I was younger, because I have friends who literally like developed like lung cancer and all kinds of like health problems from smoking. Same thing with drinking alcohol. I got friends who ruined their liver, ruined their body. They, some of them already dead, you know? I'm fortunate to have learned this kangen water earlier to keep my body healthy. And now I'm 65 years old and I'm still jumping up and down and strong and happy. Yeah. So we have the best product.
Wow. Thank you. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
For clarifying, you know, how it's not the same, you know, mundane selling of those products like soap or whatever. This is something where people come back and acknowledge, and thank you for, you know, recommending that.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, before we proceed further, are we enjoying this interaction with Romi? Please type one if you are enjoying in the chat box. If you are enjoying this session, great learning forward. Let us help Romi feel our heart and head going together. Then there is a humble request. Let us not make our special guest feel he's talking to just four people. Rest of them, open up your window screens. That's called a Zoom protocol etiquette. It is manners, part of our character and personality defines us. So can we all open up our window screens? There are 84 people here. Can we go live with our video screens? Ladies and gentlemen, for the benefit, if you thought this was the best of Romi, let me tell you, the best is yet to follow in the coming sequences. And for that, our window screens need to be on. Clap, clap, clap to each one of you for this cooperation and being on the screen. Can somebody quickly take a screenshot? This is the moment, historic moment with Romi Verdera, the master trainer, coach, mentor onto this platform. Anybody please click the screenshot for the benefit of one and all. So with this, back to Jagdish sir.
Thank you. That is required to wake everybody up. Yes. Yeah, sure. I'm sure everybody was is attentive. Yes, now. That was very good. Now, let me quickly go forward. See, let me also tell you, there are so many questions that you people are typing. I'm seeing it, but let us complete the questions and then we'll come back to the question answer session. Okay. The next thing that we would like to know from you is the most important, that you know, something that I picked up from your website about the energy opportunity and the company, you know, the ground floor versus groundbreaking. We would like to hear from you, and it's very, very important in today's context.
Okay. Having been in the network marketing industry again for so many years, I would say close to over 35 years already. I have seen all, I would say, the sales pitch that everybody else is using to recruit other people. And I would say that one of the worst pitch people could say is like, these are ground floor opportunity. We are just starting. The company is just starting. I'm telling you, run away from them. Those companies that are just starting. it's the worst thing to do is to believe that this ground floor, we are the first people in the company and we will become the millionaires later. It's like it reminds me of these test pilots who would test the airplanes for the first time and fly to see if the airplane would work well. That's what you're doing. You don't. Most of those companies, there's statistics here in America that 98% and 99% of them, they fold, you know, the companies, okay? And that's where we have our strength in this energy company. We are not ground floor, okay? And yet the opportunity is so huge. It is as if we're just starting. I live here in New York where there are millions of people, and I could go out and talk to everybody and still find that nobody knows about kangen. we have barely scratched the surface of how much could be sold. Okay, the market will not saturate. So we have a very solid company that have longevity. Okay, Enagic is about 40 years old. Okay, they later introduced this kangen water machines. If you've been to Okinawa, you will see how big the company is. We own our own golf course and country club and factories in Tokyo. Even here in America, we got about 40 offices, over 40 offices around the world. Okay, that we can operate. That's one thing I love with this company also, because in the past, before Enagic, I've been involved with the other companies. Sometimes you go into one area and you have a problem and your business like falls apart. We now live in a global economy where your business have this diversity of building all over the world. Maybe one area slows down, but the other area is like building big, you know? Like when I started, I just started here in the New York area. And I recruited Cynthia from California, and then some people from Canada. And then my other strongest leg is from Canada. And then some people from Europe joined, and then goes back to Asia. You know, the Asians actually came from United States. Most of them from Cynthia Briganti. Like for instance, Cynthia recruited Singapore and Indonesia and Malaysia. And then Samsia went to India and built India, and then went to Saudi Arabia. Okay, so this groundbreaking opportunity is like so immense potential. Okay, I remember this analogy of riding the wave. Okay, they say when you see a wave, see this surfers on the ocean.
Yep.
When you see what they do is they run to the water and position themselves for the wave to come, so that when the wave comes, they're riding on it. Okay. That's the opportunity we have in this energy. Okay, make sure you position yourself, recruit people from different areas, because when the wave comes into that area, you're riding the wave. So that's what you call, when you're talking like groundbreaking, there are so many areas that really, like I said, I live here in the New York area. I could still groundbreak in the New York area after 15 years, because there's still so many people who haven't heard of kangen, even in the New York where I started. Okay, that's our opportunity.
Okay, great. So point very well taken. Keep yourself prepared and be ready to ride the waves. The waves keep coming. That was awesome. So the next most important question for you, Romi, is again, based on your experience, we would like to hear about your $1 million secret, you know, very, okay. Very unique that you yeah. have.
Million dollar secret.
Yeah. So, okay. Like, you know, your, you know, the intention, beliefs, you did mention some things, but we would like to hear from you in this context, the the entire, you know, the secret which takes from intention to the, you know, the ideas. And you also said that it's, the idea is not enough, information is not enough. It's only a potential, but you need to take action and you need mindset which drives you to take action for success.
Okay. I have this principle in my head, okay, that I never really spoke much. It's just in my head. In fact, I never. This might be the first time. I'm gonna say it and talk about it, okay? Like becoming a millionaire, having this extraordinary life, this extraordinary success, okay. Let's say 200%. If it's 200% to do it, I know it's only 100, but I want to use 200. The know-how of how to do it, how to do the demo, how to present the opportunity, is only 20%. Okay, only 20%. Like we have probably a million distributors in Enagic, over a million, okay? I lost count already. In my own group alone, over 10,000 new distributors are coming in every single month. In my organization, over 10,000, okay, every month. I would say, out of all those people, everybody knows how to do the demo, because that's the simplest thing. Even a kid could do the demo and make it as a school project, you know? How to present the opportunity, that's another easy thing. And the 80% is, 80% is mindset. Like all those things I told you about, the belief, the faith, okay? It's all mindset. So all these top people in the company, Cynthia Briganti, Eli Duffes, Bob Gridelli, Daniel, all these top people, Sam Sia, okay, Bernard Chan, Gary Gunn, they have a certain mindset different from majority of people, okay? Like the mindset that, like, that I will win. it's like a fighter that would never quit until he gets to the top. I remember, okay, there's a guy named, okay, I have my tools here. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on 1 second.
See the enthusiasm, no? See the enthusiasm that he has. So he's one of the finest energetic leaders we have ever seen. If you feel so.
I have my books all over the place. So.
Wow. Okay.
GoPro, okay. The guy named Eric Worre. You can watch YouTube video. I would say he is the number one, I believe, trainer in the world when it comes to network marketing, building organization. You know, he used to be a networker and he just dedicated his life training network marketers. A lot of kangen distributor like learn from him, Eric Worre. And yeah. I remember a long, long time ago, hearing from him, he said, it's like climbing a mountain, okay? He said, I'm gonna make it to the top. Either you see me dead on the side or waving at the top. Okay, so that's the mindset. Because a lot of people, they quit at the slightest, circumstance of like obstacle, okay? There's one guy you might want to watch many of his, some of his video on YouTube, guy named Elon Musk. Do you know Elon Musk?
Yes.
Okay, guy named Elon Musk. And again, I read some of his books, and Elon Musk, He is the owner, founder of Tesla, Okay. Another one is SpaceX.
SpaceX, yeah.
SpaceX, okay. So if you learn his life, you would understand what I mean by mindset. This guy just would not quit. And just to give you an example, because this is the multi-million dollar mindset. I mean, he's not even talking about money, okay? He's talking of like a vision of the future. He can think as far as going to Mars and building a community in Mars, you know? And he knew that he's not gonna be alive to see it anymore, but he's still doing it. I mean, for the sake of mankind. Okay, see that vision that so far, because when we talk about like million-dollar secret or mindset, it's that really way back into the future. You could see your vision so clear, and you're going into that direction, because a lot of people cannot see that far; they could only see like a little bit in front of them. You know, you're gonna be able to think very far. And that's the mindset I'm talking about. That's the 80%.
Absolutely.
On top of the 20%. Okay, so that makes 100. So what is the other 100%? Because I spoke of 200%.
Yes.
Okay. The other 80% and the other 100% is I believe in a God who created this whole universe. Okay. Now I'm not talking of because I know we have many religions, okay? We have the Christians and the Muslims and the Eastern religion. I believe that this whole universe of ours, okay, there is a force, okay? There's a person who designs everything, created us, we are his children, wants everything good for us, and helps us. I believe in that. Because before in Ajik, remember those 20 years I was doing network marketing? I was doing everything. I was doing, I'm being trained. I'm learning everything, doing everything. And after 20 years, I had nothing to show for it. Like when I started in Ajik, I was broke. After 20 years of doing network marketing. But all those 20 years I have been praying. I said, God, I mean, lead me to the right one, you know? So I would say the hardest part of training is this portion, because if I leave that out, then I would say I missed out. I didn't train you the whole.
Romi, I have a question for you. I have a question for you. How does one sustain when the going is tough? You're not getting any signups. You're not getting appointments for demos. Your self-esteem is very low. Your uplines are not supporting. You don't see a system happening in front of you. Your family is pressurizing. They are breaking you into pieces. To take up a job, to take up something traditional, take up something secure. Now you have been networker for 20 years, okay, or more than 20 plus years. And I've also been a networker for 20 plus years now. We share the same company, Herbalife. I'm a Jim Rohn student, and of course, hardcore Herbalife, that was my first company. So we know how to sustain it either ways in all the crises. But one strong message, how to keep going when the going is horrible and terrible.
Okay. Again, going back to reading lives of people who made it. Every one of them have the same experience that they went through those trials. Like I was talking of Elon Musk. Elon Musk. Like dreamed of flying this spaceship, spent millions of dollars, flew it. And it took him a year or more with 500 employees and millions of dollars. And it It took 5 seconds to fly and blew out everything. What did he do? He started all over again. Okay? Did it all over again. Again, millions of dollars, so many people, a lot of time, blew up again. 3 times he did it. And then after those 3 failures, he made it. He was interviewed. He said, don't you think, and you will see the videos, don't you think it's time to quit? And Elon Musk said, no, I don't quit. Okay, there's this inside of you. Again, I don't know, like there, because we human beings, we all have like different beliefs. Even Elon Musk, even Steve Jobs, I believe even the people who do not believe in a God is being used by God to accomplish all these things. God's hands is behind them, okay? So I know that when I joined INAGIC on my very first day, God's hand was with me, because the very people I called on that first day are the top people in the company today.
Wow.
Could you imagine me calling Cynthia Briganti on my first day? I'm not even a distributor yet. And then the other one I called is a friend of mine from Chicago named Franny. And from Franny down the line is another Das 5 in Canada, the top person in Canada.
Wow.
So the top person in America and the top person in Canada, I got them on my first day.
Wow. Okay, now. Awesome. It's wonderful.
And then I went on and became Das 12. That's 682 and then 6812. So now what I'm saying is, if it happens once, you might say it's luck, you know, you just got lucky. If it keeps on happening, there's something behind there.
Absolutely. Awesome.
That's the answer to my prayer from 20 years of failing.
Wow. Romy, what an answer.
One more question here.
Yeah.
Philosophy, prayer is very good to boost our morale for sure. It builds our psychology. When the family gives you an ultimatum, to choose either network marketing or the family, what does one do?
You don't choose, I would say, either or. Okay. But there's some things I learned. Okay. That's going to be so hard to balance, because like you're talking about 20 years of network marketing. Mm-hmm. I came to a point where my wife was really like telling me, go find a job, you know. My wife divorced me already. We got back together. Because I would not get a job. My son told me one time, I said, Dad, okay, when he saw me, my two sons, they hated network marketing. Because I put them through hell in network marketing. They would see me make a lot of money and we would go on vacation and we will live a good life, and then everything falls apart, you know? And we are poor again. So my son one time told me, my son Jason, he's now a Das 2 going to Das 3.
Oh, okay.
Okay, today, okay. But there was a time when he was younger, he was a teenager, and told me, he said, Dad, I was borrowing $20 from him. so I could have a gasoline, so I could buy gasoline to go to my prospect. And said, Dad, why don't you drive an ice cream truck with me? Because he was driving an ice cream truck selling ice cream here in America, and he's making money, and he's got more money than me, you know? I said, Jason, no, because I'm not a poor man, okay? I'm a rich man who is broke. That's two different things.
Well said, very well said.
I'm a rich man who is broke. I have all these assets. These are all the people that I know, you know, through the years, and I get the right product, the right company. I have that asset. I'm not gonna go to a 9-to-5 job and leave that. You know? I know how to sell, I know how to prospect, I know how to motivate people, I know how to train people. All I need is the right opportunity. So when Inaji came along, it's like, I remember the story of the Beatles, you know, the Beatles.
Yeah.
And I think the drummer's guy, is that Ringo Starr, the drummer?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. One time, the drummer of the Beatles got sick. And they were supposed to have a performance, and they have no drummer. So they asked the crowd, you know, I mean, who knows how to play drums? And they tested some people, and Ringo Starr tried. And that's it. That was his opportunity. Okay. He became the drummer for the rest of Beatles' lifetime.
Yeah.
But Ringo Starr is prepared. He has done his preparation before that. So when the preparation and opportunity meets, you get lucky and it happens for you. So same thing in this business in Agic. It might look like I had 20 years of failure after failure, but then I was, again, I believe this God's way of training you, okay? He prepared me for Agic. I believe God prepared me for Inaji. And then when Inaji came along, he just sent me the right people to work with me. And I really believe that.
Awesome. That was outstanding, Romi. That's outstanding answer.
Before we proceed further, how many of you experienced the same thing what just now Romi shared? How many of you can relate to the story of Romi?
Please. Rather, how many do not?
Honestly, every networker has...
Everyone must be.
Every networker, including Jagdish sir, he will have the same homework to do.
Absolutely, all of us.
Yes.
So it's a very inspiring sharing by Romi, you know. Yes. Romi, thank you very much for that. Because everybody, it matters. Everybody can relate to what you said. And it's so inspiring, the things which you honestly, you know, you are frank enough to share, that is very, very inspiring, Romi. Thank you very much for that. Just one more point to re-emphasize that. What if you had gone and joined and took a 9-to-5 job?
Oh, I mean, what if I did that? Is that your question?
9-to-5 job, if you had buckled and if you, you know, got into a 9-to-5 job, you think you would have been in the same situation or where you would have been?
No.
Just to make the point, re-emphasize the same point.
This is my point. Okay. When I was starting 30-something years ago, 35 years ago, almost 40 years now, I guess, because I started in 1984 full-time. That was a long time ago. My friends, they are still my friends now, you know? Who were with me, I was asking, join me in Amway, in Herbalife, but the same friends, you know. Every time I have a new company, I'm asking them, join me.
Where are they?
They don't join me. They're either dead now or working still. Literally, some of them are already dead. Okay, they got sick, they got drunk, you know. They ruined their family, either that or they're still working. They could not stop because they still need the money. I feel bad for them. Like I live in a house here in Staten Island. You could go to my Facebook and see my life, or you can Google Romi Verdera, you know. I live in a beautiful house by the ocean. I have a boat that I could go to the Statue of Liberty around New York. And then, I mean, sometimes it's funny because I tell, like I would go on my motorboat with my family, drive to New York, and you would see this other boat, these big boats where the tourists come, and you're there like saying hi to them. You know?
Wow. It's like, awesome.
It's fun. You know?
Oh, you can, that skyline is fantastic. I think you are waterfront, right? Was it Hudson? Yeah. I mean, like Newport area?
It's like New York.
Long Beach?
No. Staten Island.
Okay.
Staten Island. But I go in the water every day when the weather gets nice. I just love being in the water, you know, every single day. So I have this big boat at the marina. I have a smaller one right at the backyard. I push it and I'm out there.
It's a lovely area. You know, my daughter lives in Newport. She keeps sending photos, you know, the skyline with this Statue of Liberty and all.
Yes.
Yeah. Awesome. That's fantastic. Thank you very much. So your friends must be now, you know.
Yeah, we're still friends. They come to me during the summer. We hang out all the time, but I feel bad for them. They didn't join me. Now their kids are joining my kids.
Ah, okay.
You know, because they're telling their kids, you better join Romy's kids, you know. That's the second generation now.
Awesome, awesome. Thank you. So before we go to the next question, please type what is 200% that you got from Romy. And you can type your percentages and your, you know how mindset he has made it clear, and 100% is God. If you agree, you type two, all of you, please. Okay. See, the next question we would like to ask you, Romy, especially for those, you know, who are looking for this as a business, you know, as a business option. The so-called Kangenpreneurs, what do you think is the Kangen return on investment, ROI?
Okay, that's also the best, you know, investment that anybody could do. In my case, when I joined, I purchased the SD501. They didn't have the K8 at the time. So here in America, it's $4,000, okay? But if you really do your job right, okay, my case might be, I would say, extraordinary. You don't have to do it in 90 days like the way I did. I became a 6A in 90 days. By becoming a 6A, I must have earned about $60,000-$70,000 return on a $4,000 on the first 90 days. And that's just on 100 machine on my first 3 months. By the time I got to the sixth month, my group, you see the genealogy and the list of sales, my group already sold 300 machines on the sixth month. Okay, 300 machines. Now, if you do the calculations and how it comes out, the commission you see there, that was about $180 in commission on a 300 sales in the group. You see it right there. By the end of the year, 2006, that was my first year, 2006, my group was selling over 500 machines per month. Per month. Now, that's when I did a video. Remember I told you I did a video? I hired my son to work for me full time. And all he was doing was duplicating the videos. We bought this duplicating machine because, again, I'm saying there was no YouTube videos then, okay? You don't have to do that today. You can just send the link and you can send it to a lot of people of the Kangen demo, you know? So I created the DVD and distributed 40,000 on my next year, 2007. By the end of the next year, which is my second year, my group was selling over 1,000 machines per month. Okay, by the end of the second year. And the rest is history. Yes. I'm on my 15th year now and just kept on growing.
We remember you said 10,000 machines per month, something like that now.
Yes. Now.
Wow. Awesome. Yeah.
And okay. That even if I don't go out of the house and do nothing. I just speak on Zoom videos, you know. Actually, that's one thing good with network marketing. Okay. With network marketing, in the beginning it's hard because they say network marketing is like a revolving door in a building. People come in, people go out, people come in, people go out. And you have to be bringing in people faster than they're going out, you know?
Okay.
Otherwise, if they're going, more people are going out, they're you're not bringing in, the building will be empty. And then you're a 6A with 100 people and nobody's helping you, you know? So you don't want that to happen. 6A, 6A2, that's two. At least you should have some people who are continually working and bringing in people. So as you build your group, you have to maintain those momentum in people. But then if you really keep on maintaining it, it will come to a point where your organization have a life of its own, independent of what you do. You could stay back and watch it grow because there are people building it already in the group. So you just keep on doing it until you get to that point. You don't give up until you get to that point. A lot of people give up in between and they move to another company, try all over again, and they move again to another company. They never get to the point where they were able to build a group big enough to be self-sustaining and growing on its own.
Ladies and gentlemen on this platform, once again, come on screen, open up your window screens. I have some good news for you. While we are doing this session, I'm so super excited. There was a sudden realization for me when I was listening to the whole story. Ladies and gentlemen, come on this video screen right now. I'm going to share something very, very special here. I realized something that our grand upline is Romi Verdera. If Cynthia is under Romi Verdera, then we all are your downlines. And we are meeting that DNA, the source DNA, like they say, return back to origin. We are connecting today to our original DNA, Romi Verdera, as our grand upline. Thank you, Romi, for being here. We all love you. We are part of your genealogy, your line of sponsorship, your kids, and we always welcome you. Today is a very special moment, this realization. So gratitude and thanks for all the wonderful sharing that you have showered on all of us today. Yeah, over to Jagdish.
Yeah, thank you. That's fine. That's great. So we are part of Romi family. Okay,
yes.
Great to know that. We are privileged to be part of it. Yeah, fine. Thank you. The last two couple of questions for me, and very important. So it is very important to know. You very nicely highlighted the kangen return on investment. Now, related to that, the question that everybody would have is, what is the future of energy? The growth potential, and also, it would help, how it was, say, 10 years back, today, and 10 years from now.
Okay. The future of Enagic.
Yeah.
Like any other company, sometimes challenges come, But you have to know that we have been growing since the beginning. Okay. For instance, when I was starting, this was 15 years ago, the very people that helped me start my group on the first 2, 3, 4 years, I mean, they were already dust 3, dust 4, they went high. And I know that there are like things on the internet that says, we are a better company. We have better machine. Our machine is cheaper. Enagic is just like selling so expensive machine because it's a network marketing company, and the distributor get all the money, all those things. One thing I learned 35 years ago is not to listen. Not to listen. I remember, a friend of mine, he's still my friend. He told me the story of two frogs in a drum of water, and they were trying to get out of the drum, And people would come and say, "No, you're not gonna make it. You're just gonna die there," the two frogs. Eventually, they try to kick, get out. The one of the frog, he died. He just stopped kicking and just died. The other one kept on trying. Finally, he was able to go out. And then my friend told me, why did that frog got out? How why did he get out? And I said, I don't know. And then he told me, because that frog is deaf. He doesn't hear the people telling him that he's not going to make it.
He was not biased.
Yeah. The same lesson I learned from Walt Disney. Like I tell you, I read there. How did Walt Disney build the Disneyland and the Disney World in Florida, Disneyland in Florida? He built the Disneyland during the Depression. Everybody was telling him, you're not going to make any money. It's Depression. People had no money. Who would go to a park? He still did it. And he knew people would do. So same thing when I was in Enagic, when I was starting. Even my very own first leader who joined me came to a point and quit. They would have been multimillionaires today. They quit. They missed it, you know. I feel so bad for them. But what they've been telling me then is the same thing that people today are telling, you know. This is a hard business, you know. There's so much competition on the internet. They're selling it on Google or YouTube or whatever, you know. They tell that their plays are more, all kinds of things. And again, I'm a Bible reader, so I get lessons from what I read there. And there's a lesson, the particular lesson where I get this is the parable of the sower, you know, where a farmer throws the seeds, and it got scattered. Some seeds fell on the rocks. It's not going to grow. Some seeds fell on the soil, but they are like thorns, you know, and kill them. Some end up on the good ground. The one that fell on the good ground, they grew. So in this business, I learned all I do is give the information. If they buy, they don't, they badmouth me, doesn't matter. Because the one that are buying, I only said a few and they're buying already. The one that won't buy, you gave them the whole everything and they still won't buy, you know? So what I do is I just look for the good grounds. Some ask me, how do I convince my friends and my classmates and my family? I said, no, I don't convince anybody. I'm not in the business of convincing. I'm in the business of throwing the information. And those who will buy and those who will get it and they'll buy, you know? Because if you focus your mind on the naysayers, okay, on those who say negative and those who question you, you're gonna drain your energy. You're gonna lose energy. And I want to do the business happily, you know. And the happy way of doing the business is to talk to people who would listen. And they're out there.
There's so many of them.
They're out there, there's so many of them. So leave alone all those negative ones. So you just have to be a better prospector.
Yeah, Romi, on behalf of all your children over here, I have a special request to make. Can we extend this program by under 25 minutes for the
benefit? I'm okay. Yes. Okay. I'm okay.
Thank you. Great, great. Thanks, Romi. Yeah. Love you. We are getting to hear you for the first time at this level. Yeah. What we are going to do from here, Jagdish sir, we have two more questions for Romi from the panel, and after that, we'll take a half a minute or 1 minute break. Anil will do that. And then there are a lot of 6A2 leaders, 6A4 leaders on this forum. We would want to give them an opportunity, a chance to at least ask one question to you. They're all experts. They've been in the industry for 20 plus years, and they would all love to say hi to you. We all are your kids. Okay.
Okay.
That's why we need this extended session. Sorry about it. Apologies.
But I'm okay.
A lot. Over to Jagdish, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Romi, for agreeing to extend. So I have this, the question to end. It's two questions, but part A and part B of the same question. Now, this session, as you see, is so useful for people to, you know, listen to people who are successful, to get motivated, to develop belief, and so on and so on. So this is what is this, like education, self-development, so on and so on. This is what we do on Fridays. And Saturdays, as we said, it is primarily the product demo and the compensation plan. We are successfully running this 35, and we have global audience even here. You know, this is only on Zoom. We have hundreds of them on the Facebook, okay, watching this session. So the question is, you know, what do you think, you know, is the significance of such a platform, okay, for those who are at different stage of, you know, their growth in this business, and also the ones who are yet to join, okay, like how this helps. And also like to also ask you to share your experience about this particular panacea to working in water talk show.
Okay, can you repeat the question?
Yeah, so the question is, what is the significance of this type of platform, Panacea S2O platform? Basically, it is open to all, across all lines of sponsorship. It's a global platform. We have people attending from all, you know, US and, you know, all continents. And also, we are doing it successfully for 35 weeks by now. We started in during pandemic, you know, that was an opportunity. Okay, we started, you know, when people said, you know, oh, it's all over. Okay, that's when we saw there is so much to do. Okay, then we saw the gap existing about for the beginners and also those who started who needed motivation. So we designed this in a manner, education, skill sets, okay, and continuous motivation, and also testimonies and listening to the successful people. All that has been happening. You know, people like Tamia, Amanda regularly does demo every month. Then Sihatop has been there, JVBO, FSPO has been there, Samtran has been there several times. You know, Dr. Kaz, we started with him. You know, that is international, and we have you know, like Shashi, we have Anilji, and so on and so on. So many in India as well. So we wanted to hear from you the significance of such a platform for the people who want to get into energetic business.
Okay, that's a very good question. Because I myself, when the pandemic started happening in, actually, it became strong in March last year, and I was in the Philippines. I was vacationing there. I'm supposed to go back to New York March 28, and a week before my flight, the government like locked us in. We cannot fly anymore. I got stuck in the Philippines for the next 4 or 5 months. I didn't get back home until end of June, you know. And my first reaction in March was kind of like anxiety. I said, what's going to happen now? Like people by downlines cannot go to demos anymore. I cannot go anywhere anymore because we're so used to the actual demonstration. And I was anxious in the beginning. 1 second. It's my wife's phone. I don't know how to shut it off. Anyway, my first reaction was, what's going to happen now, you know? Surprisingly, March ended the first month and the sales were the same, like all over the world. And then I'm watching my genealogy, the end of the month, and also my check, you know, because it depends on the volume of the whole group, it keeps on growing. In fact, at around July, August, it was like a record-breaking like growth. And then I understood what was happening. The distributors are learning how to do the Zoom, like the my own son, Jason, for instance. He's almost at that street. My own son, it didn't affect him because he was using the internet even before the pandemic happened. Okay, my son, he like in 2019 and 2020, he spent a few months in Ecuador, a few months in Australia, a month in Australia, 3 months in Mexico, like 5 months in California. My son keeps on moving. He lives on like 7 or 8 suitcases with his wife and the 2 kids, and he just keeps going everywhere. he just loves to travel. My son and his wife and the 2 kids. Okay, they're in California now. But he do his business on the internet. So I found out that the reason why the business has been growing, and I think maybe for 2 reasons. One is we're selling a health product. And this kangen water is for health, you know. And the second one, the platform, our business model, doable on the internet. Okay. Because when the pandemic happens, a lot of companies fell apart. But the other companies that adapt to the internet, they grew. They grew bigger than the other companies, like Amazon, for instance. Their business just went so bigger when the pandemic happened, because everybody's ordering their boxes, whatever they need in the house, through Amazon.com. In America, they're building like so many Amazon.com centers now, even here in the island where I live, you know, huge. So the companies who were able to adapt to the internet, they grew. And we are one of those companies. We passed through, in my 15 years in this company, 2 crises, global crises. And the first one was in 2010 to 2012, when we have the financial crisis here in America. Companies are going bankrupt, real estate is going down, people are losing their jobs. There are so many foreclosures of houses in the banks, banks are closing. And while those were happening, my kangen business was going up and up and up. That was when I was getting promoted to DAS 2, DAS 3, DAS 4, DAS 5 during those financial crises. And then the second one was the pandemic. And it grew. It just kept on growing this past year. And it's because more and more distributors are learning to adapt to the Zoom seminar of training. We are really... 1 second. So we are really, I would say, went through 2, I would say, global crises, and we proved successful, and we proved that we're growing despite it. So I'm happy. It seems like this pandemic is good for us. You know? We learned
how to... Very reassuring.
Okay, yeah. Robin, I have a question for you.
Yes.
What is your talk show experience of today?
Say again.
What is your talk show experience of today? Did you love the talk show experience?
This session.
This session?
Yeah.
I love it. because I love this session because like I said, doing it on the Zoom is almost like a whole lot easier than me traveling the world, going into an airplane, appearing in front of people. You know? I found out that the same thing, and even it could be done better through the Zoom than flying. You know?
Yeah.
Because I get to reach more people during this pandemic.
People across the geography, across different continents. Uh-huh. Be able to hear you, and even after this question, they will be able to ask you questions,
Yes.
Almost talk to you straight. Okay.
Yeah.
So fine. I think that was awesome. Romi, I think the questions that we had client, the panel had decided. We almost done with that question. And it was a wonderful sharing, lot of experience, lot of learning for us. We have all taken notes, you know, several pages we have noted down. Thank you very, very much.
You're
and it was very useful. And so I think that we have questions to come. Okay. So before we go with the questions of the participants, before we take the question, we have a small gesture from the Finnish H2O. This is Kalparuksha is a tree of life. Okay, it's a tree of life. It's a wish fulfilling tree. That's what is firmly believed in India. It's a that is something that we plant for every occasion. We have the speakers, the guest speakers coming, and please accept this as a token of our gratitude and love for having given your precious time and sharing your very, very valuable experience. So I just read it for you. Romi Verdera, honored with Kalparuksha Tree of Life, two bountiful trees, and the trees for ecotourism in Sikkim, India, and planted on this day by Panacea H2O. We will be able to share the location of that place, and whenever you visit India, you will be able to visit that location as well. It will also be shown on the Google map, so you know where it is. And we, it's a tree of, water. It's also what is represented here is tree for water. Okay. And the message is the yes, unification, that initiative we started, one world, one family. In India, in Sanskrit, we call it as Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, means one world, one family. That is what is our culture, our Sanskriti, that is what we believe, entire world is one family. And this is what we present, and kindly accept our token of love.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, welcome. Over to Anil. Can we please conduct the question answer session, Anil?
Yeah, before that, we have a small promotion for tomorrow. The narration, Karish, Anil, to share that slide and take over the project. All the 62 and above leaders. We have got Shani Shankar, B.R. Patil, Santosh Tiwari, and Naveen. Four of them.
Yeah, while we are waiting, Romi, I very much enjoyed this session. I'm very much, thank you very much. I feel blessed. Thank you very much.
I'm not able to figure out where this noise is coming.
Yes, we'll show the slide for tomorrow and then take quick questions from 6A2 and above. Naveen, B.R. Patil, Shali Shankar, and Santosh Tiwari.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much, Romi. That was fantastic. So, ladies and gentlemen, so extremely sorry about this. We have overboarded, but I think it is worth the time here because Romi is such an amazing person. A water story, million dollar secret, million dollar story. So, here comes what we do every Friday. We have the education program, followed by, we are doing this narration flourish on Saturday, where we do a demonstration.
Yeah, here.
So, tomorrow we're going to have Darish and Flourish, and the person who's going to do it is none other than our dear one from northern part of India, the 64 leader, Santosh Tiwari, sir. He's an amazing person and very, very charismatic personality, and he's the one who's going to do a demonstration, and with our beautiful, gorgeous host, Divya Chaudhary ma'am, and one of the most powerful, human entrepreneur, rather kangen entrepreneur, and she's the one who's going to host today. So, ladies and gentlemen, please block your calendar for 9:34 p.m. IST. 9:34 and all the way till 11 p.m. IST tomorrow. It's going to be a Nourish and Flourish by Santosh Tiwari, sir. And the host is Divya Chaudhary, ma'am. So that's it. That's for tomorrow. And now coming back to the question and answer from our senior leaders. So we will start with Santosh, sir. So I'm going to, Santosh Kumar Tiwari is a 6A4 leader from India, Romi, and I'm going to unmute him here. So Santosh, sir, if you could unmute yourself and you can put your question, sir. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Anilji. And lots of thanks to everyone. Hi, good evening, Romi Verdera ji. So good to see you and listen you. So I have learned so many things from you. So just my question is, some leader told us that this business, if we want to build a sustainable business, we have to go deeper and deeper. So there are some big leader, they are like 6A2-6. And like you, there are some leaders 6A10-2 or 6A12-2. So just I want to know that what should we do? We should go deeper and deeper in two leg only, or we should do more width? What is the ideal business structure? Just I want to know about ideal business structure. Yeah.
Okay. From what I learned, even with the Sinter Briganti, it's a lot better to build sideways. Yeah. Like I never put anybody underneath somebody. Now I did it with myself and my wife and my son, okay? But the rest, everybody I sign in, I sign them sideways. That's why I became a Das 12. What happens is, even in the beginning, if it gets too deep, you run out of the 8 points right away. Also, when there are people in between who are inactive, they're just eating up the points. Yeah. And then when they become inactive, that points goes to the company. Okay. You don't want points going to the company. It should go to real people and yourself.
Yes.
Okay. That's personally what I believe. Sincha explained it to me. It's hard to explain. But when Sincha played the numbers with me, I believe her. She's my downline. But I tell you, Sincha is very good at numbers. He's very good at analyzing compensation plan. And when she explained to me, better go sideways, I believe her. You know, I believe her. Because what happens is, you could, I would say, try to build two legs deeper and deeper. But then if it's not really, if it doesn't really happen the right way, that you have a shell organization, you have a structure, but then it might be empty, you know? Now, if I do it sideways and they really build the business, then it's a true way of building the business. There are people there working. So it's not just like I designed this something so I could go. Because you could be DAS 2, DAS 3, DAS 4, and like I said, if there's no volume, it's still not gonna give you a good return. So it's better have people who built your legs on their own than you trying to manipulate it. Okay, like for instance, when I started, I got Cinta Briganti. Now, she built right away. I didn't even have to do anything with that leg, Cinta Briganti. And then I have the Eastern group headed by Joe Reed. So I have their Tamiya and Anna Wilshire and all the New York and the Eastern United States people. They became DAS 3, DAS 4, okay? But then, they did not go higher than DAS 4. And then all of a sudden, I was betting in that to bring me to DAS 6, okay? I needed a DAS 5. Nobody became DAS 5 on that leg. But then I have another leg, which again, just put on the side before, that started building on its own. Dante Kalinisan from Canada. And he built all the way to DAS 5. Wow. Instead of, so although my New York group didn't go any higher than DAS 4, I have another leg who built on their own and make all the way to DAS 5. That's why I became a DAS 6. Okay, so it's better. I mean, personally, I think it's better to let it grow the natural way and have real people building the business than trying to manipulate it and designing it. And you're trying to force it to happen, you know, when you do that. When you put one people under each other and then they become inactive and then it grows deep and then you make less money. you might make money in the beginning because you get the bonus, but eventually if there's nobody there and you just design it that way, it might not bring you like longevity.
Thank you so much for clarifying this question, because there are so many leaders, they are building this business like binary plan and they are promoting like anything, this plan like binary. So yeah. Thank you so much for clarify this. And now I got my answer that what I have to do exactly in this business. Thank you. Thank you so much, Romi.
You're welcome.
Fantastic, Romi. That was so amazing and great question, Santosh, sir. Thanks a lot. So over to B.R. Patil, sir. Quick one, B.R. Patil.
Yeah. Good morning, Mr. Romi. I'm B.R. Patil from Mumbai and I'm 682. I joined company actually 2016, January. My question is actually how to find out the business builder. I have the retail sale, number of retail sale. I was into the insurance and legal, but there is a difficulty getting a business builder. So,
okay. You have to circulate to where they go. Okay. I mean, now it's pandemic time. You cannot do it, but it might still be doable over the internet because again, I discovered that there are people in my group, like the Canada group, they are internet like expert, you know, marketers. I mean, it's not, I would say it's not easy, but it's learnable because it's happening for them, okay? So there are people who learn. To give you an example, I just wrote a book and I found out writing a book, you could write a book, but if nobody see your book, nobody buys it. So no matter how good you can have the best product in the world. Like it's been said that like people will not beat a pat on your door to buy it. Okay. You have to go out there and market it. And there's a thing called FaceTime marketing that I just learned like this past few weeks to expose my book that I wrote to people. And I would say this past 30 days, maybe just past 2 weeks, I must have exposed it to over 80,000 people, the book.
Wow.
Through Facebook marketing and I just watch YouTube videos how to do it, you know. You could imagine 80,000 people, how could you? I'm talking of, they call it eyeballs, you know. You can have a good website. If there's no eyeball looking at it, no matter how beautiful your website is, it's a waste. You're the only one, only your eyeball is looking at it. So, I mean, I learned how to find a way to have 80,000 eyeballs looking at my website through what's called Facebook marketing. And I would say many Kangen distributors are doing that now.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, super.
All right. All right. Thank you, B.R. sir. So over to you, Naveen sir, if you could. So Naveen sir is 682, Romi, from Bangalore. So Naveen sir, you can unmute yourself and put your question, please.
Hi, Romi. This is Naveen from Bangalore. I have got two questions for you, Romi.
Okay.
One, whenever I speak about this business to people, not many people in India, they look down on this business. What do you have to say for that? And look, question two, yeah.
Look down on which business, on our business?
Yes. Yes, they look down on network marketing or direct marketing or even Kangen business too. So what do you have to say for that?
Okay. See this book, GoPro, okay? There's a thing called posture. It teaches you that sometimes that takes a long time to develop in a person. Like I might have developed it so strongly that people could never be negative on me. They look stupid when they tell something negative on me. Give you one perfect example. When I was starting some 15 years ago, I was doing a meeting in a living room, and this one lady keep on being negative at me, like the one you're saying, putting you down. They say it doesn't work, it's network marketing. And I told the lady, I mean, politely, okay? I told her, you know, I'm not trying to convince you, okay? I'm just giving the information. He asked me to engage me in a debate. I would not engage anybody in a debate. So I'm not trying to convince you, I told her. And she stopped. Because if you go back and forth, then he's gonna draw you. It's like a boxing match, you know. You don't want to be drawn into his side and you defending yourself. Okay, so it's a posture thing. Like in my case, nobody could tell me, for instance, that network marketing doesn't work. Like I own. I lost count. I think 6 houses, 4 in New York and 2 in the Philippines. Big houses, million-dollar homes. So what you're saying doesn't work. But people, they have this mindset where sometimes it's funny. I told somebody that I'm making millions of dollars, and he asked me, "Don't you have any other job? Don't you go to work?" I mean, how could you ask somebody if he has work, if he's making millions of dollars? Just to show you how little some people think. You couldn't do anything with it.
I completely agree. Yeah. Okay, I do have like one more question for you, Romi. Now, the entire business happening in India, definitely it's under you. You are a great, great, great grandfather in this business.
Okay.
How do you see India market in next coming few years? Maybe like another 3 years down the line, another 5 years down the line. How do you see Kangen business doing in India? How do you see the potential in India?
Okay. In India, okay, from what I know, okay, the population in India, because I saw one time when I was there, at the opening, there were 1,000 distributors. They explained how they will outsell even United States, and they really do. You know, it's like I'm shocked. But the way I saw it was because of the billions of people in India. Okay, it's like a huge triangle. Okay, there's only, I think there are over 2 billion people in India, right? The population.
There's almost 1.3 billion. Yeah.
Okay. 1.3 billion. I think I was thinking of China. Anyway, United States only have 300, so 0.3. 300 million people. You have 1.3. Okay. So we have a smaller triangle in our market. Okay. It's little compared to your market. There might be a lot of people in that 1.3 billion who cannot afford the machine, but I would say at the top of the triangle are people who can afford it, and they're probably more than the ones in the United States and any other countries. You know, also India being, I would say, an English-speaking country. And there are so many Indians all over the world. The
the market, the potential is so huge in India. Just like the Philippines, there are many companies in America who employs, for instance, this telephone, what do you call it, like customer service thing. Here in the United States, you call your bank, you think you're talking to somebody in America. No, you're talking to somebody in the Philippines. I would say same thing with India. We have a global economy now, global economy. Mm-hmm. Like yep. The playing field has been leveled. Everything communicates back and forth. So somebody in India can communicate to an Indian in the United States and in Europe, and you could build this business big. In the beginning, I was like doubtful whether, for instance, in the Philippines, this could be built, because the average income in the Philippines for one day is, I would say, the average income in the United States for 1 hour, you know. But there are distributors in the Philippines who are DAS 2, DAS 3, and there's distributors in America who could not even make it to DAS 6. You see, so it depends on the person who is doing this opportunity. So I'm yeah. saying, in India, I was shocked when I first went there. I've been there once. When, at the opening, when I went there, there were 1,000 distributors. At the opening when I went, and I said, how could this be, you know? And they came from all over India. I forgot where we went. Star Hotel, I think we went.
Bangalore, Romi, it's a Taj.
Bangalore.
Yeah, Bangalore, yeah, I forgot. Yeah. but I was shocked, you know? And then from there, I feel this thing will really like grow in India, just like any other country. And like any other country, there's no such thing as saturation, you know? People today still build houses, they still build cars, they still build refrigerators and televisions and cell phones. You know? Same thing with this machine. This will never end. This will go on and on and on until until all the houses have machines. You know, and by the time you reach some houses, new houses are built and the population have doubled. So don't believe anybody that would say there's saturation. No, never gonna happen.
All right, great, Naveen sir. Thank you so much for asking that question. So I think Shelly sir is traveling. I'm not sure whether he'll be able to ask the question. Shelly sir, not sure whether, because, and just let me try here. Shelly sir, you can unmute yourself if you're not traveling. If you are, then you know, I would request Shashi sir to come up and you know, give a word of thanks and wrap up the session. Shashi sir.
Thank you, Romi. That was an awesome, wonderful, amazing, out of this world session. And also thank you for this extension of timing. Normally we don't stretch our times. Panacea times are absolutely strictly followed, but we have broken the protocols today because we were so blessed, so happy to interact with our grand super upline line. So we wanted to take the best out of you. And how many of you really felt that you got value today? Type value in the chat box real quick. If you really love Romi and you want him again and again on this platform, type love. As gratitude, Panacea believes in happitude and gratitude, recognizing efforts of everybody. Please type yes, blessings to Romi Verdera for all the contribution that he has shared today on this platform. So that's all. Yes, blessings for you, Romi bro.
Thank you.
All the way from India. We love you. We love your contribution. This platform is ever grateful to you. And we are an extended family for you here. So you're always welcome. And stay connected. Stay tuned. Yes. All of you, come on window screens. Click photographs with Romi. Click videos with Romi. This is your golden chance to boost up. Stay motivated whenever you feel low. Look at this picture with Romi Verdera, 6A12-6. You are virtually rubbing shoulders, virtually sharing the energy, virtually sharing the platform. What better can this be? Thank you, Romi, once again from this platform. Yes, 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 blessings. And stay tuned. We catch up again. Thanks a lot, all of you wonderful people. Thanks for staying up so late, so night. All the leaders like B.R. Patil, Naveen Roy, Santosh Tiwari, all the 682 and above leaders on this platform. We have been friends of the industry for the last 20 plus years. And we love each other. The bonding and the chemistry is absolutely mind-blowing. And looking forward to great sessions in future too. Thanks, Romi. And
you're welcome. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye. Thank you, Romi. Thank you. Bye-bye.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Pleasure hosting you.
Yes.